away from Cove in Ireland to be with us today on Ireland Day.
Ireland Day.
In place of Roy Noble, who's normally here and he normally speaks. And of course we must remember George in the Evans, Uncle George. I'd like to thank Geraint and Naomi and Brad for coming down today. George has been a big driver of this remembering of St. Patrick over the years, the marking his birthplace, we think. But certainly he was captured by Irish raiders. And just there is Tavern of Banwen, or as it's marked there. Say it again for me. Tavernae.
Tavern of
Burnley. So yeah. That's from his confessions. It's worth reading. And there was George linked with a fella called John Thomas Clark, who was an American scholar from the University of New York. And he done 30 years research. And he said that this is just as good a claim as anywhere that St. Patrick passed through here. And we must remember a couple of years ago we did a project on human trafficking. Because let's remember, you know, we've got Jesse, we've got Rudy here now, and Patrick and his sister, Director, they weren't much older.
Yeah. Yeah, a couple of years now.
Yeah. We'd like to thank you, everybody, for coming here today. We don't have a vicar or a reverend to say a blessing, but I think we can all remember Patrick and George on this lovely St. Patrick's Day, and hopefully you'll join us in the rugby club after, and we'll have a pint of the black stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. Well said.
John, would you like to say anything?
No. Thanks very much for the invite.
Yeah. It was a pleasure to have you.
Side by side, we stand like brothers. One for all and all together. We will stay united through darker days, and we'll be unbeatable forever.